Vote.com. The public vote will be combined with the vote of an external judging panel, with our winner announced next Wednesday. And that winner will represent this region in a huge national competition. So get to HighlandRadio.com and start voting. Irish Music Month, proudly supported by Highland Radio, Hot Press Magazine and the IBI.
Voting closes at midnight, this Sunday, the 12th of March.
It's 26 minutes to midday and we are talking all things movies, and I'm delighted to say we're joined by the one and only Mr. Colly McFadgen. Good morning, Colly.
Good morning, Rory. It's great to be on with you again. It's always a pleasure. Although, can I start with a question before we get into the movies?
Of course.
Now, people won't know yet, but I, you know, you can see me. I can hear you perfectly coming through in the in stereo, but I can't see you. Is it true that's because you're in London getting ready to host Match of the Day?
I wish. No.
There'd be no boycotting from you, would there?
No, definitely not. I'd be there in a shot.
Well, fair enough. And it's a bit, you know, we're a bit football scores at the moment, because this month we're going to be talking loads of sequels. We've Scream 6, we've Creed 3, which, let's face it, is kind of Rocky 9. We've John Wick 4. And, you know, as a Man United fan, I'm just glad Transformers 7 isn't for a couple of weeks yet, so we won't be mentioning that one. So where would you like to start today, Rory?
Well, you know, I mean, I'm looking at your background there, Colly. I mean, I know where you want to start. Let's go with Scream 6.
That's it. There's a very scary picture, and then there's the fella behind me as well. Ghostface is back again. I suppose what's amazing about this, the original Scream, which I remember going to this cinema to see myself, and it was quite shocking because it was the first sort of horror movie that was made for people going, we know you've seen horror movies. We know you're in on the joke. And, you know, that guy always dies. This girl always survives.
Yeah.
And we're going to play with that. And one of the amazing things, I'm going to do a slight spoiler for the first Scream 30 years ago or whatever it was. To kill Drew Barrymore off right at the start was mind-blowing.
Nobody saw that coming.
I assumed she was the star of the movie, that she was going to be, you know, what Jamie Lee Curtis was to Halloween. Mm. And it was a real shocker. So to keep on going and produce something as fresh as this is really surprising, because it has got great reviews. Now, I have to say, when this opened on Wednesday, I was doing a special introductory screening of On Colleen Kuhn. So I wasn't able to see it yet. But I sent a couple of colleagues of mine who are absolute horror nuts, and they were delighted in it. And I think one of the reasons, sometimes when a movie, you know, when they're famous for being in one location and they move to another location, it really is kind of a boring phrase. But because in Scream, the whole point is who's the killer, it could be anyone, to move to a massive city like New York, to be stuck on the subway in Halloween when all the people are in costumes thinking any one of these people could be the killer, is a great idea. And I know you don't mind a horror yourself, and is this one you would like to see?
And look, it's one I probably, you know, it has piqued my interest purely because of, you know, as you say, it's a new location. And I really want to see, you know, does it still have legs? Because, you know, it's the same concept. It's the same, you know, it's basically the same everything, but in a whole new setting. And it's number 6, you know, so I want to see.
And like, I there was definitely a dip. I think it's around 3 and 4 weren't great. 5 was a real return to form, and they brought some of the old stars. And I think what's happening now is some of the people involved in making it were massive fans of the original Scream. So they're bringing some fresh blood, pun totally intended, to it. And one of the things Scream does, in Scream, they've all seen this, the horror movie Stab, which is based on the Scream murders. So there's jokes within jokes within jokes. And one of the chaps I work with, a fella called Niall, who really knows his horror, said, while it is, you know, a bit scary and gory, everyone also were bursting out laughing when people were killed, because it's so knowing. It's such a movie for horror fans.
So it does, it keeps the parody, you know, it keeps the parody element and, you know, the movie within the movie sort of thing and parodying itself and parodying its predecessors.
Absolutely. And it's aware of exactly the conversation you and I are having, going, oh, like, lads, come on, it's number six. How much can you do? Yeah. And they're playing with that, which is probably the only way to keep it fresh. It is clever. It has made more money on its opening weekend. This is something they do. They open on a Wednesday and they count that as the weekend. Now, I try and get overtime for that. But they have had the biggest opening of all their movies ever. And to do that at number six is something pretty special. And we're going to be talking in a minute about another sequel, which is still keeping on going. Now, you and I, when we were talking, I think it was last month, it could even have been January, we were saying, ah, come on, lads, give us some new movies. However, if you do, you can take the old movies and put a fresh spin on them like this. It is worth going back and revisiting, because they're not just showing us the same movie. They're showing us, they're making a movie going, aha, we know you saw the last one. We're going to catch you out. Mm. So fair play to them. It's not easy. And it's been a big hit already. Even if I get a little bit squeamish now. I must admit, this is probably a wee bit too much gore for me. But then again, I'm not 16 anymore. 16-year-old Collie would have thought this is the dog's business completely. And that's really who it's made for. If you fancy a bloody good time this weekend, it sounds like just write the movie for
you. All right, so that's Scream 6, and that is in theatres now. And we move on to another sequel, and one that is still still has legs. And this was one that I was unsure about when the first installment came along, because, as you say, is it Creed or is it just Rocky with a different name?
Well, I suppose this is the first one that I really can say it is just Creed, because Rocky ain't there for the first time in all the movies. And, like, again, as a franchise, you know, Rocky, there was very few surprises, I suppose, aside from the very first one, which, of course, was an Oscar winner. And it's such a big popcorn movie, you'd forget that the first one was kind of a serious movie. And then, you know, we had Clubber Lang and Ivan Drago. And, okay, we'd Rocky V. With, I think he was called Tommy Gunn, the Irish fighter. That was rubbish. Yeah. That was absolute rubbish.
Even Stallone admitted himself that it was a bad choice.
My ring's outside now. Yeah,
it was a bad choice.
Yeah, absolute rubbish. But having said that, Rocky Balboa was great fun, and you thought it was done there. And then they said they're doing a spin-off with Adonis Creed, Apollo Creed's son, and you're going, yeah, I don't think so. But what they did, and we talked about this when we talked about Ant-Man last week, they brought in Michael B. Jordan to play the role, who is both a movie star but also a tremendous actor. And they, you know, he was kind of the same stories with a modern twist as before, but they know what they're doing. This is a popcorn movie of the highest degree. I had such a tremendous time. I saw this movie last week, and they brought in as the bad guy, the same bad guy in Ant-Man, the guy called Jonathan Majors, who's going to be a megastar because he's just so good in this role. And there's a little bit of nuance as well, Rory. He is the bad guy, but you're also kind of going, he has a point. You know, he has been treated badly by the system. He was Adonis's Creed's buddy when they were young. He was locked up in prison, and he always felt Adonis Creed took his life. Mm. He was the one who became a star. He was the better boxer. And he comes back, he gets out of prison, they become friends. But look, Rory, you already know where this is going. If you've seen a trailer, you know where this is going.
Exactly. So you're not going in here looking for surprises, basically, is what you're saying.
He's not going to turn out to be a ghost. It's not a sled. There's no twist endings here. But what there is, I suppose this slight twist is that after all this time, much like Scream, and when we were talking about upcoming movies last month, I didn't expect to be saying this. This is as entertaining as any of the previous Rocky or Creed movies. It is so much fun. It looks fantastic. Michael B. Jordan actually directs it himself.
Yeah, yeah.
The music's great. They're going, I'm enjoying this, but they are going to give us a training montage, aren't they? Absolutely. 100%. You know, and, you know, it's because it's made in 2023, the soundtrack is much more hip-hop than Eye of the Tiger. But then just when you think you're going, you're not going to get it, you just hear a bit of ba 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 ba, and you go, yeah,
of course, we're going to be disappointed. If you go to see a movie in that Rocky universe, you don't get a montage, you're coming out disappointed.
Yeah, and of course, is there a sort of fight that you go, okay, those scenes are cool, but if people actually box like that, they'd all be dead by the third round. 100% nobody can see, but they get up off the canvas when they shouldn't. And all the time, the movie critic in me is thinking, oh, I should think this is rubbish. I should think this is rubbish because it's predictable. I've seen this before. Why is there an ear-to-ear grin? I'm like the Joker from Batman watching this. Just time to push in more popcorn because it's so well done. And sometimes, you know, Rory, sometimes you want to go out for a nice meal. Sometimes you want to go for comfort food, a pizza or a spaghetti bolognese, and you go, okay, I know exactly what's in this, but I'm going to love it anyway. I was so surprised.
I think people forget that. People forget that sometimes we just want to go to the movies or sit down in front of our TVs and just be entertained. We don't want to go into deep thought. We don't want to be having this deep and meaningful discussions afterwards. As you said it, you just want to go and, you know, pig out on comfort food and have an ear wall-to-wall smile for 2 hours to escape. And people forget
and you,
that.
And you also nailed it there. 2 hours, not 3 hours, James Cameron and Avatar. As much as I enjoyed it, and I did enjoy it, not 3 hours. This is about an hour and 53 minutes. My bum, as I walked out, went, thanks very much, lad. That was just about the right time. And sometimes, and like, I love, you know, we've talked about like Banshees of Inisherin and Empire of Light and all these complicated movies. And that's great fun too. But I don't want all that. Sometimes you want steak. Sometimes you want comfort food. Sometimes you want to try that new Thai restaurant. It's about variety and choice. But if I do go for comfort food, I can't be disappointed. And that's why, you know, I'm very nervous about the Indiana Jones movie because they let me down with Crystal Skulls last time. Because if you're going to make a movie as famous as the Rocky Creed universe, you cannot disappoint the fans. And this does not disappoint the fans. Two thumbs, two gloves up, Rory. Try and go and see it when you get a chance. I think you'll really enjoy it.
Brilliant. Okay, right. So that is Creed 3. That's in theatres now. We're going to take a quick commercial break. We're going to come back and we're going to talk Academy Awards right after this. Don't go anywhere.
Stop. Highland Radio are going to Scotland from Monday the 1st of May to Thursday the 4th of May with the very best of music, and we would love for you to join us. Staying at the 4-star Crown Plaza Hotel in Glasgow, we are bringing with us some of the biggest country stars, including myself, David James, Declan Nairne and Robert Mazzell, to name a few. You will enjoy luxury travel to Glasgow, 3 nights dinner, bed and breakfast with music and entertainment each evening. Join us on the Highland Fling to Glasgow this May for only €575 per person. To book, call Highland Radio today on 07491 25000. Early booking is advisable. Single supplement applies.
Super Value makes saving money as easy as
1, 2, 3, go.
1. We match Aldi and the products you love. 2. Great special offers like Andrex Classic Clean Mega 9 Roll, only €7. Exclusive to Real Rewards members only. And 3. Money off vouchers every week on the app. Follow the 1, 2, 3 and save money at Super Value. T's and C's apply.
Ireland's most exciting new folk group, Kjol, play the Mellon Country in Omagh on St Patrick's Night and the Clanry Hotel Letterkenny on Saturday the 18th, bringing traditional Irish folk music to a new generation. Don't miss Kjol. Friday the 17th in the Mellon Country Inn and Saturday the 18th in the Clanry Hotel. Check out cureband.com for details.
A concert to celebrate Seachtain na Gaeilge and to support Míva Fire Service will take place in the Parochial Hall, Carrigart, this Saturday, 11th of March, commencing at 7 p.m. Either winter in the Hetche, agus Siam Sirila, by Kiol, Auraniat, Drama, Cupan Té, agus Nyartilla or Shul, Le Lein na Hihe. Bígi Lein, Sir Chadisha, O Horli Hondai, Wunanal, agus LPT Huishgirch, Wunanal.
The 100th anniversary of the Drumbo Martyrs will be marked with a spring school in the Villa Rose Hotel Ballybuffet this Saturday the 11th. Join the discussion with historians and experts on Drumbo past, present and what is to come. This free event is open to the public. For further details and registration, see eventbrite.ie.
Minutes to midday, we are talking all things movies with the one and only Mr. Colin McFadden. So far, we've had Scream 6 and Creed 3. It's a season of sequels, and very good sequels by the sounds of it. But It is Academy Awards weekend, and we've got a huge Irish contingent heading over to LA for the glitz and the glamour. Collie, what are your predictions? What are you thinking?
Well, funny, I was thinking about that when we were at the break, because we kind of briefly mentioned football earlier, and one of the issues with my team being half good again is that you get hopeful and you get disappointed. Usually I look forward to the Academy Awards not caring who wins, whereas this time I'm really quite excited and I'm a wee bit nervous, because we all thought Banshees of Inisherin was going to do really, really well at the Academy Awards. But lately, it's been all about a movie called Everything, Everywhere, All at Once. That's hard to say. And I think that might pip it to a couple of the big awards. But I'd still be reasonably optimistic that Colin Farrell might just get the award, which would be brilliant. Because, you know, he's been great for years. And we were talking earlier about Michael B. Jordan and Jonathan Majors doing both the movie star stuff and the actor stuff. Colin Farrell has been doing that too. He was great in The Batman, even though most people didn't realise it was Colin Farrell.
Yeah, that's right, actually.
But in Banshees of Inisherin, I couldn't take my eyes off him, except maybe when Barry Keoghan was on the screen. The only thing about their Oscars, because both himself and Brendan Gleeson are nominated for the same film, they might take away from each other. Now, my favourite movie of last year absolutely was on Colleen Kuhn. I mentioned it earlier, The Quiet Girl. Because it just, I think, you know, we were talking about twists and surprises. I just thought, oh, it'll be nice to have this little Irish movie, you know, based on a novel I hadn't read, you know, in Waterford Irish. Although I must admit that that ad you had just before for Shocked in the Gaelge realised how much I have Dublin Irish rather than full-on Tyrconnell. How I hear me, Jane or Scorby, sort of Irish. I was struggling there, but I did better with the Waterford Irish and on Colin Kuhn. But it really shocked me. And I went, oh, that's a lovely movie, but I don't think people are going to see it. Rory, people are still going to see it in cinemas in Donegal this week. It's about 42 weeks since this movie was released. Even Top Gun and Elvis didn't last that long. That is amazing. And even though they're up against All Is Quiet on the Western Front, which is Netflix money, so I just can't see them taking the final step. But it's like Finn Harps making the Champions League final and saying, oh, well, they didn't win. They've already won by getting there.
Exactly.
It is amazing. And you never know. Miracles do happen.
Exactly.
One, though, I think might happen is a movie I haven't seen. It's the only one on the list I haven't seen. It's called An Irish Goodbye. It's a short movie about two brothers saying goodbye to their mum. Mm. And I think that might actually win, which would be amazing because so many people. The McDonough's themselves behind Banshees of Inisherin and The Guard and all that, they started making short movies and that they won an Oscar and that gave them the money to make their proper movies. So it would be amazing for the Northwest and Ireland if we were to win that.
And in the short film category, isn't it?
That's in the short film category. And of course, you know, Paul Mescal's in it too. Nobody'd heard of him a couple of years ago and he's there in the Oscars. And, you know, maybe it might just happen. I don't think so this time. But then he's another film coming out we should mention. I think it's on March 24th or the 31st, called God's Creatures. It's set in Kerry, but it was made here in Donegal.
That's right,
And Emily Watson, And that looks really interesting. Dark movie, but it looks really interesting.
Yeah. So, like, I mean, a huge Irish, the biggest Irish representation we've ever had at the Academy Awards. I mean, we've always had something there in, you know, the animation category or the short film category. But we're all over it really this year in all the major categories, or most of them.
I assume it'll be a green carpet, not a red carpet. And like coming up on St. Patrick's Week, surely we'll win something. And also there's quite a few people nominated for things like costume. I know one of the chaps nominated for Avatar is from Dublin. Mm. You know, there's other awards. And I think, you know, things like Game of Thrones being filmed here gave people an opportunity. Near me in Ballyshannon, they've been filming Obituary. And there's loads of local people involved, not just in, you know, being extras, but in the tech side. Mm. And that's amazing too, because not just about actors and directors, it's the people who do the sound, do the effects and all that. It's amazing.
And those categories are often, those categories are quite often forgotten, you know, and usually, especially in the highlights that you would get on on TV the following night, it's just a quick sort of a recap. Oh yeah, and this person won for sound, this person won for best makeup, you know, and it's sort of just pushed to the end. People forget about what it actually takes to put a production like that together.
100%. And I tell you one thing, those movies we talked about, and like, this has been a very positive month so far. I don't know, maybe there's some stinkers around the corner, but I've really enjoyed the movies this month. Try watch any of them without the slight special effects or the makeup or the editing, and it's rubbish.
Exactly.
It's not just about actors, it's not just about directors, it's not even just about the story makers, it's everyone together. Again, let's finish with our sports analogy. It's all about a team, you know. It's about the coach, it's about the person who drives the bus too. None of it works unless all of it works. So fingers crossed, we'll have, you know, look at the Irish given the weekend. That's it. I'm even wearing green, Rory. I wore it on purpose.
Of course.
Yeah. So hopefully,
very quickly, every year, there's always a standout moment at the Oscars. We all know what it was last year. With such a big Irish representation this year, do you think that moment or one of those moments might go to the Irish? Do you think they'll do us proud?
Well, you know, is there any chance if Colin Farrell wins, he could get through their ceremony without swearing? Yeah. I think that might be it. Or, you know, maybe a speech Oscar. Maybe put Paul Mescal, if he wins,
exactly,
might say again in Irish. Who knows? Kildare man winning an Oscar. Crazy.
Exactly. Well, who knows? Monday morning will be very, very interesting. Colly, a pleasure as always to talk to you. We'll talk to you again next month, April, can you believe? We'll talk to you then. And do you have any idea what's coming up?
I think we're going to be talking about Super Mario Brothers and more sequels. And hopefully God's Creatures will have been out. We might have a bit of a serious chat about that. Great. Irish movie.
Well, we look forward to that. Colly, thanks as always. We'll talk to you next month. Take care.
Bye.
Take care. That's Colly McFadgen there, talking us through all things movies and what's coming up in a theatre near you over the course of the next month.